screaming something about an axe.
An axe? Ah, no. It was Max. Max what? Still following me around again, trying to get his job back. I'm not coming to you. 2 years have been now. No matter where we are, the Gamma, the Wanker, the MCG, there he is, hustling with. Ah. Now I've started letting nothing.
Welcome back. Just preparing the grain of the pitch for a second. Ba-da-ba-ba. It's just going to be the main background before we lay down the pitch. So what we're doing today is the 1990 Cricket World Cup semi-final against South Africa. And that shot showing the poor South African men walking off after being run out in a huge confusion. It should have been an easy win for them, and Australia managed to snatch it from them. Great day. Sending this all the way to Canada. Oh, this is loud.
Check 1-2, check 1-2. Jeff, is my hair sticking out here?
No, Richie, it looks fine, mate. Stand by, everyone. 20 seconds.
Feels like it's sticking out. How's the suntan? Am I brown enough?
Yeah, brown is very rich. Here we go, everyone.
Yeah, well, I look a bit pale on this monitor.
No, the colour's a bit washed out on that monitor, Richie. You look...
Here we're a bit dark here. Yeah. A bit too dark. I need a bit lighter. A bit more yellow.
Welcome back to the Adelaide Oval, and welcome to our viewers in England and India and New Zealand and right around the world. You are joining us here for the first time today. And my word, it really has turned out to be a marvellous day for cricket here. Although at around about a quarter to ten this morning, a mass of thick black clouds was just hovering over the Adelaide Oval and really looked like it might threaten to disrupt the start of play in this very important World Series Cup fixture between England and Sri Lanka. And then fuck me if they didn't just disappear quicker than you could say, gee, it's going to piss down, and play got underway as scheduled right on 10 o'clock.
Yes.
Now we can tell
still
you that Alex
like
Stewart won the toss here this morning and sent the Sri Lankans into bat. And they did
pretty
well, really, to be all out for 182. Well, easy conditions for scoring runs here today. And we can also tell you that Mataya Muralidharan is not taking his place in the Sri Lankan side today. Mataya's a bit flat. Apparently he's been up most of the night chucking, and this morning Mataya very worn out. And they're resting him so that he might be all pumped up for tomorrow's game against Australia. Some pretty awful jokes there, but who gives a fuck? So the Sri Lankans sent into bat by Alex Stewart on a pitch that Tony Gregg described earlier on today as an absolute motherfucker. Now, we'll let you have a look at Tony's pitch report in a moment, but first of all, the Sri Lankan batting card. And they did reasonably well under the circumstances, Sri Lanka, all out for 182 or 49.2 overs. That's not too bad in these conditions. Very hot and steamy here as the day's gone on. And you can see there that the opening pair for Sri Lanka, Siwanda Piyasiria and Arsene Wanachivijaya too, both getting a start. Piyasiria eventually dismissed for 28. Arsene Wanachivijaya too played well for his 42 off only 55 balls. What a crummy singer, top scored with 60, and he played some glorious strokes in his innings. But then the collapse really came for Sri Lanka, as you can see there. Ramatunga down the throat of the skipper, out for six. The Carter Bunch of Lavender and Shabdamindavas put on a handy seventh wicket partnership of 32, but neither of them able to go on with the job, and as you can see there, the tail end offering no resistance at all. In fact,
all right,
the last two Sri Lankan batsmen dismissed with successive deliveries, without adding to the total. Darren Goff claiming a feel like a chunder and I might need a poo too, one after the other. So the Sri Lankans all out for 182. Now, just before we show you all the dismissals, I mentioned earlier the condition of this Adelaide Oval pitch here today. And for the benefit of our overseas viewers who've just joined us, or if you missed it earlier on, here's what Tony Greig had to say this morning in his pitch report.
Well, Richie, I can tell you that it really does look to be a marvellous one-day strip here today. It really is a credit to the curator, Bob Geronkle, and his staff of groundsmen here. I tell you what, the last time I saw this many cracks in the one place was at last year's gay and lesbian Mardi Gras. Just look at some of these fucking beauties here in front of the popping crease at this cathedral end. Now, I'm not even going to bother putting the keys in there. You could park the car in these cracks. And they really are going to play havoc with some of these batsmen here today. And with some of these quicker bowlers like Mullally and Goff for England, or I feel like a chunder and I might need a poo too for Sri Lanka. Well, if they were to get the ball seaming off some of these cracks, we could see some real carnage here today. And I would not be surprised if someone has their fucking head knocked off. Anyhow, let's hope so. Take a look at our weather ball now, and you see there that the wind is coming from the northeast at a rather gusty 35 knots. Although coming more out of the south now as I speak, the temperature is a very warm 38 degrees, and the humidity a very sticky 82%. However, the Bureau have in fact forecast that there could be a chance of rain a bit later on. But at the moment, when you look at our player comfort meter here, well, I think you can expect that there'll be quite a few sweaty jock straps out there today. Probably lots of spots and pimples and rashes building up around the genitalia area of some of these players. So all in all, stinking hot, strong wind, and the pitch an absolute motherfucker. Looks like we're in for a pretty good game here today, Richie. Back to you in the central missionary position.
Tony Greig there with his pitch report from earlier this morning, and it was a combination of the condition of the strip and the fact that there might be a bit of rain around later on that would have influenced Alex Stewart's decision to send Sri Lanka into bat. And the Sri Lankan top order batsmen would have been shitting bricks this morning, I'd say, but in the end managing to put on 182. A pretty good effort, that. We're going to show you all the Sri Lankan dismissals now, and the first man to go was Shiwonda Piasaria. Was an absolute ball tear of a delivery, this, from Darren Goff. Piasaria beaten by sheer pace in the end, and umpire strikes back no hesitation at all in giving him out LBW. I said, why not your vagina too, was the next man to go. It's good to see him opening your vagina too. Hasn't opened for a while, and he played pretty well today for his 42. There was nothing fancy about it.
Not many explicit words being used. Hugo Webb, what's up, buddy?
And it was a sensible knock from him, but then Darren Goff produced a couple of very good balls that swung a bit, and eventually Goff taking out his middle stump, and that was the end of the vagina too. The next man to go was Dearie Me Wakrami Singer, and it was a brilliant performance in the end from him. He had trouble getting into a groove earlier on, Wakrami Singer. Seemed to be having problems with the pitch, but eventually found his rhythm, and Dearie Me Wakrami Singer top scored in the end with 60. Before Mark Elam really got one to swing, man, it was far out, I dug it. And Dearie Me, what a crummy singer, going for the big hit, dancing down the pitch.
Yeah, mate, actually, surprisingly less detail than you'd think, because the
so it was a pretty good start there.
Pitch is so far away.
Pressure and
their faces have...
Then the middle order collapse started.
It's just more shadow than anything.
Van Gogh was a painter and he cut his fucking ear. Both went very cheaply.
I reckon it might end up being a little easier than suspect. Anyway, see how I go.
A few balls later, he cut
his fucking ear. Focus on getting the pitch right first.
Didn't hear the call from his skipper, Ramatunga down a throat, and eventually he took off, but...
And this is hard. It must be fucking hard getting the cricket pitch right in real life, let alone on a painter.
The Sri Lankan skipper wasn't able to steady the ship either. In the very next over, Mark Elam had Ramatunga trapped plum LBW for 6. And then came that 7th wicket stand between a cut a bunch of lavender and shoved them into bars. A cut a bunch of lavender put on 16 runs before he was caught at mid-on by Hollyoak off the bowling of Wells, and shoved him into vars, was dismissed a short time later trying to lift Robert Croft over the infield. He didn't quite time it and was caught a deep cover by Graham Thorpe. It was a marvellous effort that from Thorpe. He came all the way around from where he was fielding near in the slips to take that catch. And Sri Lanka really in some deep foot at this stage with the score at 8 for 179. I feel like a Chandra and I might need a poo too. Never look comfortable out there. They were the next pair to come in for Sri Lanka, and with a fired up Darren Goff steaming in from the cathedral end, it was just a matter of time. And I feel like a Chandra and I might need a poo too very quickly on the way back to the pavilion without adding to the Sri Lankan total. Like a Chandra copped a brute of a ball. It flew off the pitch at an alarming speed. Chandler just trying to get the fuck out of the way there, and it came off his glove and went straight through to the keeper, Stewart. And I might need a poo too. Just hanging the butt out to dry there, no footwork at all. A thick outside edge to Stewart, and Darren Goff brings the Sri Lankan innings to a close. The not-out batsman was an even crummier singer who didn't get to face a ball, and the final score, Sri Lanka, all out for 182. Well, the players and umpires not quite ready to come back out to the centre just yet. Just a few dark clouds starting to appear here at the Adelaide Oval. Not really looking too threatening, though, at the moment. And we should see both teams back out there in just... Ah! Ah! Ah!
We apologise for this breakdown in transmission. We seem to have lost our signal to the Adelaide Oval, but we hope to take you back to the cricket shortly. We apologise for this interruption to our apology. We hope...
TV.
But not just me, but the country team. They're sort of my boys, if you know what I mean. You know, I thought captaining Australia was a pretty tough job. But I can tell you it's absolutely nothing compared to looking after this mob. Let me see, there's Bill and Tony.
What a rich one, all.
Yeah.
Barbara and Bernie and Dina McDermott are here, whoever it might be, in this super Australian side. Season 92, 93.
What about Big Moon?
Yes, maybe.
He's a hero, this man.
Oh, come on, turn it up, Bernie. He might be to you.
Well, he's got a lot of guts.
Well, he is too much food. Now it really doesn't matter. Look, no one gives a stuff if Big Moo's a little fatter. Just as long as we're thrashing those Pankies or Bombs or Sonaka or the Woodies, doesn't matter where they're from. It might be India, South Africa, Zimbabwe or New Zealand. But if I don't take a breath, I reckon I just might be killing my nervous. And I'm trying to carry on and do my best. Come on, Rich, call him, baby, take a rest. Ah, stress.
Come on, Rich, we'll get through it.
Ah, jeez.
We don't fight, but you can do it.
Ah, thanks a lot, fellas. Think I'm okay. I'll live another day to say what a marvelous strain.
That's a marvelous boy.
Yeah. All right. Under the pitch, almost. I tried a bit first, but then. O-U-S.
My name is Richie, and I'm the king. I'm the king commentator, I'm the number one thing. But I'm a singer too, and I'm a jammer. And that's when I become MCG. And I feel a star coming under. Just as you
Thanks, Pat. Marvellous to be joining you in the flat for the second time today.
Gee, a home early. What, are you sick or something?
Don't ask, love.
You sounded a bit sick on the telly this morning with Max Walker. Oh, and that was very nice of me to give Max another go, Rich. He still sounds very good, doesn't he?
Oh, it's on shuffle.
Welcome back to the kitchen, Bob.
Thanks, Pat. Tomorrow must be ready in the kitchen for the first time today.
Sounds great, Bob.
Thanks.
What's that fun,
Bob? Just something I read in the column here. Super piece of writing, that. Really funny stuff.
Oh, that's good. I just heard on the radio there might be a bit of rain going on.
Oh, really? No, what a bugger. Oh, well, make sure you throw the deck of cards in front of you, Bob.
Just go and iron your jacket for me.
All right. Now, the cream one, the bone, the off-white, the white, the ivory, or the beige, huh? Right?
Yes, I know.
Ah, super cup of that. Matter of fact, love, marvellous breakfast all round.
Oh, thanks, dear.
Ah. There's my cap. Okay, love. I'm off now. Have a nice day. Mwah. Yeah, super kiss that. okay, Dale. I'll be back here at the flat in just a few hours, and I'll look forward to your company then. $16. Keep the change.
Oh, thanks, man. Hey, man, listen, I'm in trouble with getting what I know your face from. Haven't I seen you on the bloody TV somewhere?
Well, yeah, as a matter of fact, you might
have. I thought so. It just up to that bloke that does a bloody weapon thing in the mailbox. What are you down this way? Down the hell this way?
Yeah, that's me.
Hey.
with the same name. How are you, girls?
I'm good, thanks. I'm on TV.
Ah, thanks a lot. So do I. G'day, boys. How are you going?
Pretty good. Hey, Richie. How about an autograph?
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Who do I make it out to? Just the dear Richie?
Ah, piss off, you cheeky little bastards. Go on, piss off.
Right, still working on this cricket pitch, trying to get the 3D angle of the ball. And if not, if I've gone too high or not.
Shit, the bloody max.
Well, not high enough.
G'day, Max.
G'day, Rich. I was just wondering if you'd heard anything about me getting a job back on the commentary team.
No, Max, I haven't. Like I've been telling you all along, mate, it's not up to me.
Yeah, I know, Rich, but they might listen to you if you put in a good word for me, you know?
Yeah, well, Max, I have been putting in a good word for you. I'm a big fan of yours, you know that. I don't think they should have given you the flick in the first place.
Yeah, I know. That's great, Rich. I really appreciate it, mate. I was just wondering if you could hassle him again for me, maybe convince him to give me a quick shot today. Maybe just let me call about 15 minutes to go or something to show him I've still got what it takes.
Max, I'll do my best. I promise you, I'll do my very best.
Oh, gee, thanks, Richie. I really appreciate it, mate.
Yeah, okay, Max. Security? If Max Walker comes within 10 feet of this fucking door, shoot him, okay? Straight into the name pronunciation rundown for this Pakistan team today. Let's do a quick roll call first. Tony?
Yeah.
Bill? Bill? Anyone seen Bill?
No, I certainly haven't.
That's it. Okay, Ian?
Yes,
sir. Ian's brother Greg?
Yes, sir.
Morning, Richie. Morning, all. Sorry I'm a bit late.
Again? Look, I've had just about enough of this, Bill. If you're not interested enough to turn up on time, there are plenty of people around who are, mate. I don't need to remind you how interested Max Walker is in getting back on the team.
I can certainly fucking do not. That's why I'm late. Bloody Max is silly bastard. He had me bailed up downstairs. He's off the fucking wall, Richie. He has been ever since he got the arse. That's how you're right.
The man is
done here. Yeah, I know.
Okay, settle down. Look, I've asked security just this morning to try and keep him away. Apart from that, I don't know what else I can do.
Well, for starters, you can have the bastard barred from this part of the broadcast area.
I'm sorry, what was that, Tony?
I said, for starters, you can have the bastard barred from this part of the broadcast area.
No, I heard you, mate. I'm sorry. I just want to hear you say it again.
Okay.
Come on. Can we get back to this roll call, please? David?
Present.
Michael?
I'm cool, man.
Richie? Oh, that's me. Okay, all present and correct. All right, now, the pronunciation of the Pakistan players' names. It's been fucking atrocious all season. And today, we are going to get it right. Now, I'm going to run through this team from top to bottom, and I'm going to say the names, and then I want you all to repeat them together nice and loud and nice and clear, okay? All right, then. Javed Jamal Fahmeendan.
Javed Jamal Fahmeendan.
Nice and loud now. Wasim Radamad Ruta.
Wasim Radamad Ruta.
What do you mean, was he?
What do you mean, was he?
Come on, Bill, concentrate now. Asif Givashi.
Asif Givashi.
Adsay Givashi.
Adsay Givashi.
That's good. That's pretty good. Amir Sahail.
Hail, Richie. Hail the great man. Hail.
No, Bill, that's his name here. Dickhead.
Sorry.
Concentrate now.
Come on, it's not my bloody fault. These bloody Pakistani names are just ridiculous. Some of them sound like questions, some of them sound like square words. They're just too bloody hard to pronounce.
They're
going to have to agree on a sensible form of these fellas' names at the start of the season. It's a bloody nickname if you have to. I'm telling you what, it's just ridiculous expecting a man to analyse the game and commentate as well as analyse three quarters of the alphabet and try to get a bloody name out of it.
Yeah.
It's just ludicrous.
It's only two
wrongs.
Okay, fellas. Look, I'll have a yarn with the ACB about it. But for the moment, can we get on with the job at hand, please? Listen carefully. I keep my teeth in a jar beside the bed. Never been behind bars. Was he a crim? Lammy's Roger.
I think I've gone too high on the pitch.
All right, fellas, can I have your attention, please? Fellas! All right, now, I just want to go over the commentary schedule for today's game. Okay, now we're going to kick it off with the Chapel Brothers today.
What? Oh, come on, Richie, you can't be serious. We always go first. The fans love it. A bit of colour, a bit of light, plenty of experience. That's what's needed in these one-day matches. We must get off to a good start or lay the foundation for the rest of the team to build on as the game progresses.
Quite finished, are you, Bill?
No, I'm not, Richie. I think it's absolute silliness to abandon what's been a winning formula like Tony and myself. Vitally important these limited overs games have an experienced opening combination.
Bill, shut the fuck up. We're going with the Chapels, and if you don't like it, then piss off and I'll get bloody Max or someone else to do your job.
Good luck with him, Greg. Have a good call, fellas.
Excuse me, Richie, I'm sorry to barge in like this, mate. I just thought that while all you fellas were together here, I might be able to say a few words on my own behalf to see if I can...
I'm sorry, Mr. Banner. I just turned my back for a bloody second. Bang, just passed me the flash. If I called him to stop, he wouldn't have a bloody gun
yet. Okay, security, okay.
Anyhow, fellas, listen, now that I'm here, I was happy you might consider giving me another go.
Max, tell your fucking story walking, pal. Security, get him out of here.
Oh, no, Richie, please.
No, you've gone too
please,
far
Rich.
This time. Max, on your bike.
Oh, jeez, Rich, I'm sorry.
Come on,
I'm sorry.
Come on now.
I won't do it again, I promise. Oh, no, Richie.
Anyway, come on, fellas, let's get back to business.
Richie, darling, make up now, sweetie.
Yeah, okay, Kevin. Now, listen, fellas, while I'm having my makeup put on, I want you all to have a few minutes warming up, okay? Try and G each other up a bit. Bill and Tony, you work on the aggro thing. And Ian, you work with your brother. Guard him. Wind him up. Get him excited.
Okay, Richie, darling. Sit still now for only Kevin while he makes it all beautiful.
Here I am, Kevin. Ah, gee, careful. You just got me in the face with your banger.
Sorry, love. Lucky it wasn't a ring.
Hey, Kevin, tell me, do you like picking it all? I mean, you spend so much time around the game, day after day. Do you actually enjoy it?
Well... sort of, Pat. I don't mind getting caught behind now and then.
Eh?
As long as I'm batting from the Paddington end, though.
Alright.
Used to be quite a handy tail end. They're in my time.
Okay. Sorry I asked that, Kevin. Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Alrighty, there you go, darling. How does that look?
Gosh, Drift, Kevin, what have you done?
What?
Oh, I look like one of Kirby Ambrose.
You wish. What's the problem, sweetie?
So dark. What shade of
Schedule to go through and some notes to make. Oh, please, Richie, I'll only be a second. The rest of you have the others to look after. I don't like Wendy Jr.
Okay, Bill, put it down here on the desk. Not near my nuts.
Oh, no. Sorry, Richard. What are you doing again?
Yeah, look at this.
Say you're sorry to Richard. You said you're sorry, Richard.
Yeah, okay, Bill. Go on, off you go. Hurry up.
Thanks, Rich. I'll love you a minute.
See you later on, mate. All right, then, listen up now, fellas. Fellas! Okay, now we're on air in just about 10 minutes. So, Tony, I think you better get down to the centre for your pitch report.
Yes, okay, Rich.
And you know they're predicting rain later on.
Yes, I heard the forecast. You read the cards?
Got them right here. Now, off you go, and Ian, you better get going too. Get yourself ready for the toss of the coin.
Yes, okay, Rich.
Now, the rest of you fellas, just keep practicing the Pakistani names, going over them in your mind, make sure you know them. And Greg, you make sure you're warmed up because you're first in the commentary box with your brother. Come on, let me hear a bit. Show me what you can do. That's good. That's pretty good. I like the way you're cutting off the start of each word there. That's nice. And the same upward inflection on everything is good too. You'll be annoying the shit out of the viewers in no time. To the Sydney Cricket Ground for this preliminary match in the Benson and Hedges World Series Cup between Australia and Pakistan. Both teams on 2 points coming into today's game, and I'm sure they'd both be equally keen to pick up another two here too. Now the two teams for today's match, firstly Australia, and just the two changes there to the side that played the other night at the MCG. Mervyn Hughes comes in for the injured Mike Whitney, still being troubled by that groin of his. And Greg Matthews also comes into the side. The ACB apparently think he's worth another 10,000 bums on seats here at the SCG. They regard him as a bit of a loose cannon. And for Pakistan, Asif Givashid and Adsaeed Givashid come into the side, replacing Ahmed Ibn Agaibar and Diwarawaka. Well, it's nice and bright and sunny here at the SCG right at this moment. There's some talk of rain, possibly a bit later on. And to find out more about that and the condition of the strip, let's go down now to Tony Gregg for his pitch report.
Yes, thank you, Richie. Well, this pitch in pretty good shape here, but I think we're more likely to have some trouble with the weather here at the moment rather than the strip. There are some very nasty dark clouds looming not too far off in the distance. Now, the Bureau have in fact forecast rain for later on this afternoon, but I expect we're going to be seeing it sooner rather than later. Anyhow, let's take a look at the condition of this pitch in pretty good nick, really, for a one-day game. It's quite flat, not much grass on it, should be reasonably fast, but still the batsmen will be able to play their shots. Although you notice just over here in front of the popping crease, a couple of large cracks have opened up rather a long way. Now I don't have the keys with me today, Richie's confiscated them, but you see here that they've come apart far enough for me to put my foot in there. Oh gee, the Better watch out, actually. Lost one of the old Julius Morlows last season doing this. But certainly these cracks are going to make this pitch a little bit unpredictable, and the batsmen will definitely have to be on their toes. Turning to our weather wall now, and what an impressive looking piece of equipment it is. Very colourful and high-tech. But in point of fact, it's all bloody useless information that won't make a rat's arse of difference to the outcome of this match. The player comfort level, however, is of great importance in these matches. We've actually got a completely new system devised for calculating the player comfort level this summer. David Boone has been kind enough to come over and help us out. Thank you, David. David's been warming up out here in the centre for a few minutes. Now, if you wouldn't mind just loosening your strides for me, David, so I can slip my hand down there and check the moisture content of that jock strap. And I can tell you it's very moist and sticky indeed down there. Absolutely saturated, really. Just look at how much moisture comes out when we give it a little squeeze. Yeah, it's very humid, overcast conditions here, causing a fair bit of discomfort to some of these players before the day's out, I'd say. Just cough for me, will you, David? Yes, well, everything else seems to be in order. That's it from down here, Rich. Back to you now in the central commentary position.
Yes, thank you, Tony. Rather you than me. Anyway, it looks to be a reasonably good one-day strip out there. But as Tony said, the weather looks like it could be more of a contributing factor than the pitch here today. The toss of the coin, always of vital importance in these one-day matches. Here's Ian Chappell now with the two captains.
Oh, well, now, I agree. So what do you want? You want $100 in heads?
Yeah.
Okay, well, it's $100 in a time. What about you, Charlie?
I'll have $100 on a tail, too.
Yes, thanks, Rich. Okay, Jarvid, if you'd like to do the honors, AB, you can call.
Hey!
And this is a fucking head.
Lucky
prick. What are you going to do? Okay, well, Alan Gordon's elected to run with the wind towards the Paddington end, so that means Pakistan will have the kickoff. Good luck, fellas. And back to you, Rich.
Thank you, Ian. Ian Chappell there with the two captains. Well, the players and umpires will be making their way out to the centre shortly, and we'll come back in via CG in just a few moments. Keep going. Second day are we playing here? Is everyone going completely mad? Who's batting, for heaven's sake?
I'm sorry to butt a jib, Mr. Benner. I'm afraid we've got another problem.
Fucking great. What is it now, security?
It appears Mr. Laurie and Mr. Greg have barricaded themselves in the commentary box.
Oh, Streak, you have got to be joking.
No, Mr. Benner, I'm afraid not.
We were looking all right for a cricket pitch.
Hey! Hey, you two! What the bloody hell do you think you're doing? Bullshit you are! Get out of that commentary box now, both of you. You won't be on the team for much longer now. Get out of there. Yes, I can hear you, Jeff, but you better get down here fast, mate. We've got big trouble.
Why, what's the matter?
Just get down here, will you, Jeff? I'm outside the commentary box.
Why, mate, I'll be down there in a sec.
You want me to shoot the deer, Mr. Benner?
That won't be necessary just yet, thanks, security.
Hey, Richie, what's the problem?
Ah, Jeff, are you ready for this? Bill and Tony have barricaded themselves in the commentary box.
What?
You heard me. Look at them. They're demanding they go first. Just great, isn't it?
Well, listen, we'll have to try and sort it out during the outbreak, Rich, because I've got to get back to the
controller. Yeah, okay, Jeff. You fellas are gone in there, you know that, don't you? You're dead meat.
Security, keep an eye on him.
Ah, oh, shut up, Bill, you dickhead. Welcome back to the SCG. Players and umpires are out there in the centre now. Alan Gordon won the toss and has sent Pakistan into bat. Wasim Radamed Rudra, and what do you mean was he, are the opening batsmen out there for Pakistan. Bill Laurie is in the commentary box, and alongside him is Tony Gregg.
Yes, thank you, Richie. And welcome to a few on some Twine World Sports, wherever you are around Australia. Could be a good game, miss. Both teams
keen to try and build on their Benson and Hedges World Series Cup points, Tanny. Good morning, Bull.
Good morning, Tony. Good morning, all. Tremendous day here today. Tremendous atmosphere around the ground. We've bowed in already. Both these teams desperately wanting victory here today. Trying to consolidate their position on the ladder and assure themselves of a place in the finals.
Yes, indeed, Bull. Pakistan, of course, the World Cup champions. After the Bastards narrowly beat South Africa last season.
Oh, come off it, Tony. They were thrashed. You're not going to crap on about that again, are you?
Well, Bull, if they say in South Africa, I don't want to be a bore, but I do think Pakistan were lucky to win that match.
And you're a wanker then, Tony.
But be that as it may, this match here today against the Aussies will be the only thing on Pakistan's mind at the moment. Especially these two openers, Wasim Ranamaruta and Wunimin Wasim. And it's going to be Wasim on strike, and he's about to face the first ball of the day from Craig McDonald. Just let's take him through the keeper.
Very important for Pakistan to get off to a good start here today, Tony. Wasim Ranamaruta probably holds the key here today for Pakistan. Been in tremendous form this summer, hampered by a bad groin injury during the World Cup last season. Continue to plague and stop his orders. He start having to have a complete groin reconstruction and miss the tour of England.
Yes, well, he's certainly been playing well, Wasim. Now that he's been able to put his groin behind him.
Yes, Tony. Apparently he's far more comfortable there. Understands the first time this type of operation's been performed. It's actually called a groin relocation.
Yes, Bull, well, it's certainly worked wonders for young Wasim Ranamaruta, who's really found some form so far on this tour. He's been scoring freely in some of the lead-up matches, had some great partnerships. Indeed, his batting average on this tour is quite remarkable. You see on his chart there, Wasim has an average of 193. He hasn't been dismissed so far on this tour, and certainly Pakistan would be looking to him to lead the charge for them here today.
Got him, yes. Piss off, you're out. Beautiful piece of bowling, Craig McDermott. That's fucked his average, Tony. Wasim Ranamaruta on his way back to the pavilion for a duck on the third ball of the innings. The only breakthrough to Australia. And that's just the kind of start Alan Border would have been looking for. Pakistan in the very first over, a one for none.
Gee, that was a pretty good start for us, Bull. A little bit of the aggro thing going there.
Bloody hell, Tony. No one does it better than us.
Oh, gee, look at Richie out there, Bob, with his face pressed up against the glass. He looks really pissed off.
Well, of course he's pissed off, Tony, but a man's got to do what a man's got to do. Geez, don't go soft on me now. Look, we're doing the right thing, getting the call off to a good start. We're the best openers in the team, not the Chapel brothers. You just can't go changing the teams willy-nilly.
Yeah, well, try telling Richie that. Look at him out there. He's fuming. Look, Bob, what's he saying?
We can't, Richie.
No, Rich, we can't.
We have to keep going, Richie. It's what the fans want.
Crap, Bill, you bloody idiot. That is crap, Bill, you stupid bastard.
Control, Richie. Are you there, Rich?
Yeah, I'm here, Jeff.
Hey, Doc, what are you going to do about Bill and Tony?
Nah, fuck it, Jeff. Let them go. If they don't come out after 10 overs, I'll get security to break the bloody door down.
Yeah, right on, mate. Stand by, everyone, please.
Welcome back. Akeem Atif and Ajab Asad have been at the crease now for Pakistan. He's replacing
Wasim Ranamaruta, who's beaten all the way up so by Magnus for Craig McDermott delivery.
Yes, Paul, this really was a brilliant piece of bowling by young McDermott. Nipped back quite sharply off the seam. Was even very slow to pick it up, and in the end, the ball has cut back a very long way indeed, and hits round about middle of the leg. Pakistan in a little bit of bother now, with Akeem Atif in a jar beside the bat, ready to face a really fired-up Craig McDermott. Just plays that one away defensively on the onside.
This is a much better start from Craig McDermott here today, Tony. He bowled a lot of loose deliveries the last week in Adelaide, especially early in his spell. He let a lot get away down the leg side. His line and length generally were pretty lackluster.
What was that again, Bull?
No, fuck off, Tony. I'm not going to fall for that one. You heard what I said. McDermott been right aligned here with his first few deliveries. Alan Ball will be looking to him today for a better performance, and certainly at the moment he's got his tail up with figures of one for none.
teeth in a garbage side bed.
It's about the big appeal he's got, is he? Piss off, you're out, is he? No, it says umpire strikes back. Oh, gee, that must be very close indeed. Another brilliant piece of bowling from Craig McDoom. He's on fire here at the Sydney Cricket Ground. The whole place is abuzz. It's all happening for the big fast bowler. And the crowd really showing their appreciation. It's a magnificent opening spell from McDermott.
Yes, well, he really seems to have mastered the
order. Let's try it out. Let's get on to the cricket players.
Nothing McDermott does is ever hot fallen. Right from the start, he's always been a very hot pass master. And it's more than a few hours hard work now. And he's this is a good way to attract his boss's attention.
Oh, jeez! Bloody Max! It's Max Walker!
Well, what an unbelievable scene! Just look at this! Max Walker is streaking across the SCG. He's completely stark naked. Well, now I've seen everything.
Yes, you certainly have, Tony. It was pretty to see, too. Just have a go at that thing, will you? I look like him in tangles.
No wonder indeed, Bill. It looks like a baby's all holding an apple. But finally, the police and ground staff security have caught up with Max Walker and are escorting him from the ground. Well, what an unbelievable incident this has been. The crowd loving every minute of it. And look at this, a policeman is trying in vain to cover up Big Max's private pocket to his hat.
He's wasting his time, I can tell you now, Tony. He's going to need one of those 10-gallon jobs.
Yes, indeed, they will both. But finally, now it looks like they've got Big Max off the field. And play can now resume. It's going to be Big Bruce Reid coming in again to draw Vegemite from here. And he smashes that one through the covers. The Boston's finally got under one. Mark Waugh is coming around, but he won't cut that one off. And under the fence it goes. And a last draw that picks up a boundary for Pakistan.
Bruce Reid just straying down the leg side there. Not happy with himself. Spits in disgust.
Yes, Paul, pretty handy split it was too from Bruce Reid.
My word it was.
And this could be an appropriate time to remind our viewers about our Wide World of Sports Golden Golly competition. If you find the best splits of the season, 1992-93, it's a marvellous competition this. We see some really spectacular gollies throughout the summer here. As Reid moves in again now to draw Vegemite for me and Dad. Just that won't go through the keeper. Now, we'll be showing the best bodies from time to time throughout this competition, and eventually we'll narrow them down to the final five. This is a replay here of Bruce Reid spinning just a moment ago. Not a bad one, this side of the ball.
Well, he's always been a good golly, a Bruce Reid. Just look at this, right off the meat of the tongue. Good more on a length, plenty of height on it from the tall man. Would be a good chance in this golden golly competition.
My word, Paul, if he can continue this sort of form, he could be taking home that beautiful antique Wedgwood spittoon. I'll be losing trophy, miss. As we move in again to bowl to drive out.
puts that one off and pants to square leg, they'll pick up a single here. Now, just getting back to our Golden Golly competition, there's a viewer's prize too for the first correct entry opened in each state. And it's your very own Golden Golly. A piece of spit supplied by the player who wins this competition this year will be 24 karat gold plated. You see a sample on your screen there, and a very smart piece of jewelry it makes too. You can hang it around your neck or make it into a ring if you like. And one of these golden bodies going to the first correct entry open in each state.
Well, that Redwood's platoon will be the last one of Bruce Rude's riders now, Tony. Akib and Jarvid are both looking a little bit more confident in the last couple of overs. And Bruce Rude coming in now to Akib. He'll be very keen to pick up another wicket here. Bruce Rude slips and falls. Oh, he's hit the ground pretty hard. Oh, gee, he's snapped in half, Tony. Oh, well, this is tragic. Bruce Reed has slipped over and snapped in half.
Well, what a disaster this is for young Bruce Reed and for Australia. Reed literally breaking in two after slipping over. We've been dreading something like this happening to the young man for years now. He's got that painfully thin physique. He's had numerous operations so far in his career, and he really is built like a beanpole.
Well, it's just a matter of time, Tony, before something like this happened to Bruce Reed. We've got more nuts and bolts in him than a bloody hardware store, this young man. I don't think he'll be taking any further part in this match, Tony. They look like they're calling for the stretcher.
Yes, well, I think we'll find they're calling for two stretchers, in fact, Bull, to assist young Bruce Reed from the field. Although he seems to be showing a little bit of reluctance to leave the field, Bull. Yes, in fact, Bruce Reed is waving the stretchers away here. Yes, well, this is unbelievable, Bull. Bruce Reed appears to be calling for the sticky tape, is he? Yes, well, he's asking the Australian team doctor to tape him back together so he can play on. And that's just an indication of the marvellous spirit and determination in this Aussie team. Bruce Reed showing a ton of courage here.
Well, he might be showing a ton of courage, Tony, but he's showing he's got no fucking brains, if you ask me. You can't just tape yourself up after you've stepped in half and expect to keep following to the best of your ability.
Oh, blow it out your arse, Bull. You've got to give credit where it's due. And certainly that's what the SCG crowd is doing here. Huge cheers going up for Bruce Reed as he gets to his feet, making his way rather gingerly back to his mark for this last delivery of his own.
Well, I still think it's a ridiculous decision, Tony. The man's just snapped in half. It's a pretty serious injury. I reckon it's absolutely ludicrous to play on and run the risk of doing more damage.
Well, Bull, I think we'll find he knows what he's doing, Bruce Reed, as he comes in with the last ball of his over to keep the team in a job site. Oh, and that's a very good ball too from Bruce Reed. But oh, what's happened here? The sticky tape's come away, has it?
Of course it fucking has, Tony.
Well, this is a real blow. Reed has snapped in half again. And oh, look out, the arms come off too as well. And his head might have come away too, has it? Yes. Well, Bruce Reed really gone to pieces now.
Yeah, he knows what he's doing, does he, Tony? You fucking wanker.
Well, this really is tragic for Reed.
Bullshit. It serves him right. I don't know who's more fucking stupid, Tony, you or him. It really was a silly decision by Reed to play on. Ludicrous. Ridiculous. Completely lacking your logic.
Well, you're a hard man, Paul Laurie. But I'm certain Bruce Reed will be taking no further part in this match. It's a big blow for the Aussies. But they're still very much on top here as drinks come onto the field. Pakistan are 2 for 30 after 10 overs.
Well, there you go, Tony. That's our 10 overs. I think we did bloody well.
Me too, Bull. Give me five. Give me five more. Down low.
Ah!
Too slow. Shit! You fall for that one every time, don't you, Bull?
Oh, you stupid prick, Tony. I think I've broken my bloody finger again.
Yeah, sorry, Bull. Yeah, I suppose we better go and play some music with Richie.
Yeah, I suppose so. Well, at least he can't say we didn't do a good job. I think we performed brilliantly here this morning. Plenty of colour. Tension, excitement, that's what the fans want. Must have a good reliable opening combination to get the call off to a good start, and I think that's exactly what we've provided here today.
Yeah, Paul, save it for Richie. He's the one you should be telling. Well, here we go. We might as well get it over and done with.
Control room to Richie. Control room to Richie. You there, Rich?
Yeah.
What's the story with Bill and Tony, mate? That's their 10 overs. Is anything happening down there?
Yes. Stand by, Jeff.
I think they're coming out now, Mr. Benner.
I think they're coming out now.
All right, blow it, I'll freeze you away.
Hey, hey, calm down, security. Put that thing away. I'll handle this. Well, Bill? Tony? That was a very, very stupid thing you fellas just did there.
Yeah, but we did a good job, Richie. You must have...
Don't start up with that bullshit again, Bill. Just shut up. Now, I'm not going to tolerate this sort of behaviour on my team. You fellas have shown a flagrant disregard for my authority, and I'm afraid I can't let that go unpunished. Now, I'll decide what I'm going to do with you both a bit later on, but meanwhile, you're both suspended from the rest of the corps. You're out.
Oh, gee, Richard, I think that's a bit harsh.
I don't give a flying fuck if you think it's a bit harsh, Tony. Security, take him out.
With pleasure, Mr. Banner.
No, not that sort of take him out, security. I mean, take him out of the broadcast area. Get him out of here.
Oh, right. Sorry, Mr. Banner. Okay, this way, please, gentlemen.
Hey, Richie, I just want you to know, mate, I don't hold any grudges. To be a grudge is nothing more than a place to fork your core.
What else can go wrong today?
Control room to Richie, you there, Rich?
Yeah, Jeff, could you quickly come down for a sec? I'm going to be in the commentator's room.
All right, mate, I'm coming down now.
All right, fellas, can I have your attention, please? All right, now, after this little episode with Bill and Tony this morning, I've decided to elevate myself in the commentary order and go to first drop.
Yeah, that's the best.
Now, I'm just trying to work out who I'm going to take in with me.
Richie, take me with your man. The Aussies love listening to me, man. The Central Pool.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you might be right, Michael. Pat up.
Cool, man.
Okay, Rich, what's the story, mate?
Jeff. Listen, I've had to dismiss Bill and Tony. They're out. Now, I've elevated myself in the order. I'm going in next, and I'm taking Michael in with me.
Yep, good idea. Yeah, Rich, there's one small problem, mate. Apparently,
Max is on the list again. Ah, fucking great. How did that happen?
Well, security escorted him from the ground and powered him as soon as
Well, you better tell security to keep him out of the broadcast area.
Yeah, mate, I'll tell him. Now, listen, there's only about a minute to go, so I better get back up to control room.
Yeah, okay, Jeff, see you later on.
Excuse me, Richie.
Yeah, what is it, Ian?
That's a little disappointment for Greg himself, but not down here, mate.
Yes, Richie, but that's right. It certainly seems a bit unfair.
Look, I'm sorry, Greg. I know you and Chappelle must be disappointed, but you'll get your chance a bit later on.
Yeah, Rich, but I was supposed to go first, but certainly.
Ian, I have had a very trying day. Now, if one more thing goes wrong, I may just flip right out. So don't argue with me, please. Can you remember the golden rule we follow around here? We work as a team, and we do it my way. Okay?
It's okay, Richie.
Now, I want you all to keep practicing, keep your throats warm, and we'll see you in 10 hours. Okay, Michael, come on, let's go.
Richie, hang on, man. I just have another quick look for my walk.
Yes, all right, Michael, but don't be too long, please. Shit of a bad day. Oh, well. Can only get better. There's no need to lock the door, Michael.
Surprise, Richie. It's not Michael.
Max! What the hell do you think you're doing? You're not allowed in here.
Well, Richie, I've got this big motherfucker of a cricket bat here that says I am. Yeah, Richie, I just want a chance to prove myself. That's all I want. It's a white girl and everything will be just fine.
Max, I can't let you call that game. Ah! Have a seat, Max.
Yeah, thanks, Rich. Yes. Nice to be back in the old chair again.
Yeah, that's good, Max.
Control room to Richie,
everything right to go down there, Rich? No worries, Jeff, everything's fine, mate. We're revved up to the max.
That's good, Rich.
Jeff, we're ready to perform to our maximum capabilities.
That's great, Rich. We're all going to have a minute to go, everyone.
Jeff? You didn't say hi to Michael.
Michael, everything okay, mate?
Yeah, good day, Jeff. No worries. Everything's cool, bud.
Max!
Yeah, good day, surprise you. How could you tell it was me?
Where the hell's Michael?
He's all right. He's outside, so we're listening to my Walkman. So Richie's asked me to sit in for a while as a guest commentator.
I did not think anyone would mind. No, it's not. Ah! Problem for me, Jeff.
Right, here we go. Stand by
30 seconds. Well, Richie, I've been looking forward to this moment for a long time now. Don't fuck it up, will we? Just play it cool and call your natural game and it'll be just fine.
Okay, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 2.
Welcome back to the SCG. 2 for 30, Pakistan, from 10 overs after Alan Ball sent them into bat. To struggle a little bit here in the last few overs. Probably like to try and push that runway along now if they're to set Australia a reasonable sort of target here. Garfield to Mike from Mum and Dad and Akiba T from Java side of bed. The two batsmen of the piece. Garfield has the strike. Ah! And joining me in the commentary box, it's a very good morning to Max Walker.
Yes, good morning, Richie. Good morning, everyone. Nice to be back in the old chair calling the game again.
Well, I wish I could say, how much we've all missed you, Max.
Well, thanks very much, Richie. It's really nice of you to say that. For a long time.
And it's going to be Greg Matthews now to take up the attack from the pen there.
There's old smoking Dave Matthews, as they call it these days. We'll send down a couple of the old offies to see if we can break up this pair. He comes down, left foot first, then the right. Left, right, left, right, right, left as the arc goes up and the ball leaves the fingers. Jarve Vegemite for me, and that comes forward and smashes that one through the covers of a brilliant piece of fielding from Alan Border, saves a certain boundary.
Super piece of fielding this from Alan Border, but it was a glorious stroke too from Jarve, dancing down the pitch. Really prominent. Runs so far in his innings, but could so easily be more than that. In fact, in the 31st over, Jarvis faced, he had two balls cut off right on the fence.
Oh, gee, Richie, that could be pretty painful, I can tell you. Almost happened to me too earlier on today when I was jumping the fence on my way out to the centre. And nevertheless, Jarvis been hitting it very solidly indeed. Showed the bowler the full 4.25 inches of his blade.
Which you also did earlier today, Max.
Richie, I think you'll find she was a little more than 4.25. Matthews again comes in the bowl now, left foot first, followed by the right. That familiar left foot right foot combination as he makes it go. Jarvan picks that one down to 5 length for a single.
Well, this could be trouble. Jarvan looking for two. He's turned blind.
Oh, gee, well, this is a tragedy. Jarvan can't see a thing. He's obviously got no idea where he's going as he tries to scramble back for a second, but he's not going to make it. Billy just flicks off the old bales and Jarve Vegemite from Rear Deck tragically run out for 12. After a freak accident of some sort, did you see what happened to him, Richie? Did he get something in his eye?
No, I didn't see Max.
Well, he's certainly a plucky little customer, the Pakistan skipper, as he makes his way back to the pavilion without any assistance. His team's in a bit of trouble here at 3 for 31. Okay, we're going to take you out to Royal Grabbing Racecourse now for the feature event of the day, the Sirloin Stakes. Here's Kenny Callender.
What the fuck's Max doing there?
Yes, thanks, Maxie. Well, they're moving in quickly now for this race, the Sirloin Stakes, over 2,000 metres. So let's check the prices for you. The top weight, Show No Mercy, is at 6-1. Summer Sizzler is at 13-2. Senior Citizen and See So Shy at 7-1. Silver Sovereign from the TJ Smith Stables is 3-1 favourite. Southern Star is at 16s. Synchronise is at 6s. Sweet Surrender starting at 7-1. Although she should start a bit shorter with the bookies. So Serious is at 33-1. So too is Simple Solution. Street Smart is at 16-1. And Tappy, the old tongue's bleeding profusely at the moment, I was done. Looks like another one of those bloody races where every fucking horse got Nash in his name. You might have to help me out, old son.
Yep, with pleasure, Kenneth, my boy. The last two are Slipstream and Sing a Song of Sixpence, and you owe me a beer, old son. Okay, well, they're all boxed and ready. Starter's got the button. And they're off and racing. Sweet Surrender, one of the best to begin. Silver Sovereign also jumped out smartly ahead of So Serious and Synchronized. Street Smart settles in behind that bunch on the inside of Show No Mercy. Summer Sizzler, a length further back to Southern Star on the outside of Senior Citizen. She's So Shy, a length further back, half a length to Sing a Song of Sixpence. Slipstream is second last and Tail Off last is Simple Solution. And as they settle into stride now, So Serious looms up on the outside to join Sweet Surrender in the lead. A length further back, Silver Sovereign on the outside of Synchronized. Show No Mercy, Southern Star. Further back is Summer Sizzler, followed by Senior Citizen. Two lengths further back to She's So Shy on the inside of Street Smart, and then a gap to Sing a Song of Sixpence. Slipstream is second last, and Simple Solution is back at the tail as they come to the 800 now. And the leader is So Serious, about to be tackled on the outside by Silver Sovereign, who's had the run of the race. A length further back to Sweet Surrender is grinding away, synchronizing hot pursuit. About two away, Southern Star on the inside of Shadow Mercy is having his ear scrubbed off. She's So Shy coming around the outside to make a line of three. Then a gap to Senior Citizen, Summer Sizzler. The fourth last is Street Smart on the inside of Simple.
Squad Squad! Halt!
Control room to security, control room to security. Where the hell's that bloody Squad Squad?
They're in position now, sir. The door appears to be pretty heavily secured, though.
I don't care. Shoot the bloody thing down if you have to. Just get Max Walker out of there.
All right, fellas. You heard the man. Let's go.
Silver Sovereign.
So Serious has dropped back to be fifth on the inside of Senior Citizen, who's putting in a late run. Synchronized has gone. Summer Sizzler is trying to get between horses. Street Smart and Simple Solution.
He's got all that bloody racket going on right there.
I don't know, Max.
How was I? Pretty good, eh? I haven't lost it, have I?
Get him out of here, will you? Just get him out of here.
Right, Mr. Walker.
I really am sorry, Jeff.
Richie, it's fine, mate. We're going to kick on without you. You just go home and rest. Now, come on. I'll walk you down. Put you in a cab. Just go home and rest. Come on. Let's get your stuff together.
Thanks, Jeff. I really am sorry about this.
It's okay, mate.
I just don't think I could get through the rest of the day.
It's okay, Rich.
Are the Chapel Brothers ready to go on?
Yes, Rich. They're ready, mate. Everything's fine. Come on.
To keep it up, vibe, and keep it interesting, okay?
Okay, Rich.
No crapping on for hours with boring anecdotes or anything like that.
Whatever.
Now, you'll probably have to rotate the chapels with Michael and David for the rest of the day.
Yeah, righto.
Because I don't want Bill and Tony back on the team today. They've been dismissed, okay, Jeff? They're out.
Fine, Rich. Whatever you say, mate.
That's it!
Now, just go home, Rich. Put your feet up and relax, okay? Watch the rest of the game on TV.
Yeah. All right, Jeff. Thanks, mate. Back up. Yeah, car 343 just picked up the SCG.
343.
Good. Ah, Check one two. Jeff, is my hair sticking out here?
No, Richie, it looks fine, mate. Stand by everyone, 20 seconds.
Feels like it's sticking out. How's the suntan? Am I brown enough?
Yeah, brown is very rich. Here we go, brother.
Well, I look a bit pale on this monitor.
No, the colour's a bit washed out of that monitor, Richie. You look great. Here we go, everyone. 5, 4.
Welcome back to the Adelaide Oval, and welcome to our viewers in England and India and New Zealand and right around the world. You are joining us here for the first time today. And my word, it really has turned out to be a marvellous day for cricket here. Although at around about 9:45 this morning, a mass of thick black clouds was just hovering over this Adelaide Oval and really looked like it might threaten to disrupt the start of play in this very important World Series Cup fixture between England and Sri Lanka. And then fuck me if they didn't just disappear quicker than you could say, gee, it's going to piss down. And play got underway as scheduled right on 10 o'clock. Now, we can tell you that Alex Stewart won the toss here this morning and sent the Sri Lankans into bat. And they did pretty well, really, to be all out for 182. Not easy conditions for scoring runs here today. And we can also tell you that Mataya Muralidharan is not taking his place in the Sri Lankan side today. Mataya's a bit flat. Apparently, he's been up most of the night chucking. And this morning, Mataya very worn out. And they're resting him so that he might be all pumped up for tomorrow's game against Australia. Some pretty awful jokes there, but who gives a fuck? So the Sri Lankans sent into bat by Alex Stewart on a pitch that Tony Gregg described earlier on today as an absolute motherfucker. Now, we'll let you have a look at Tony's pitch report in a moment, but first of all, the Sri Lankan batting card. And they did reasonably well under the circumstances, Sri Lanka, all out for 182 or 49.2 overs. That's not too bad in these conditions, very hot and steamy here as the day's gone on. And you can see there that the opening pair for Sri Lanka, Shiwanda Piyasiriya and Asit Wanajivajana too, both getting a start. Piyasiriya eventually dismissed for 28. Asit Wanajivajana too played well for his 42 off only 55 balls. What a crummy singer, top scored with 60, and he played some glorious strokes in his innings. But then the collapse really came for Sri Lanka, as you can see there. Ramatunga down the throat of the skipper, out for 6. A card, a bunch of lavender, and Shabdamindavas put on a handy 7th wicket partnership of 32. But neither of them able to go on with the job, and as you can see there, the tail end offering no resistance at all. In fact, the last two Sri Lankan batsmen dismissed with successive deliveries without adding to the total. Darren Goff claiming a feel like a chunder, and I might need a poo too, one after the other. So the Sri Lankans all out for 182. Now, just before we show you all the dismissals, I mentioned earlier the condition of this Adelaide Oval pitch here today. And for the benefit of our overseas viewers who've just joined us, or if you missed it earlier on, here's what Tony Gregg had to say this morning in his pitch report.
Well, Richie, I can tell you that it really does look to be a marvellous one-day strip here today. It really is a credit to the curator, Bob Geronkle, and his staff of groundsmen here. I tell you what, the last time I saw this many cracks in the one place was at last year's gay and lesbian Mardi Gras. Just look at some of these fucking beauties here in front of the popping crease at this cathedral end. Now, I'm not even going to bother putting the keys in there. You could park the car in these cracks. And they really are going to play havoc with some of these batsmen here today. And with some of these quicker bowlers like Mullally and Goff for England, or I feel like a chunder and I might need a poo too for Sri Lanka. Well, if they were to get the ball seaming off some of these cracks, we could see some real carnage here today. And I would not be surprised if someone has their fucking head knocked off. Anyhow, let's hope so. Take a look at our weather ball now, and you see there that the wind is coming from the northeast at a rather gusty 35 knots. Although coming more out of the south now as I speak. The temperature is a very warm 38 degrees, and the humidity a very sticky 82%. However, the Bureau have in fact forecast that there could be a chance of rain a bit later on. But at the moment, when you look at our plant comfort meter here, well, I think you can expect that there'll be quite a few sweaty jock straps out there today. Probably lots of spots and pimples and rashes building up around the genitalia area of some of these players. So, all in all, stinking hot, strong wind, and the pitch an absolute motherfucker. Looks like we're in for a pretty good game here today, Richie. Back to you in the central missionary position.
Tony Gregg there with his pitch report from earlier this morning, and it was a combination of the condition of the strip and the fact that there might be a bit of rain around later on that would have influenced Alex Stewart's decision to send Sri Lanka into bat. And the Sri Lankan top order batsman would have been shitting bricks this morning, I'd say, but in the end managing to put on 182. A pretty good effort, that. We're going to show you all the Sri Lankan dismissals now, and the first man to go was Shiwonda Piasaria. Was an absolute ball tear of a delivery, this, from Darren Goff. Piasaria beaten by sheer pace in the end, and umpire strikes back no hesitation at all in giving him out LBW. I said, well, not your vagina too, was the next man to go. It's good to see him opening your vagina too. Hasn't opened for a while, and he played pretty well today for his 42. There was nothing fancy about it. Not many boundaries in his innings. He prefers to stroke your vagina too rather than swing his bat at it. And it was a sensible knock from him, but then Darren Goff produced a couple of very good balls that swung a bit, and eventually Goff taking out his middle stump, and that was the end of the vagina too. The next man to go was, dearie me, what a crummy singer. And it was a brilliant performance in the end from him. He had trouble getting into a groove earlier on, what a crummy singer. Seemed to be having problems with the pitch, but eventually found his rhythm, and dearie me, what a crummy singer top scored in the end with 60. Before Mark Elam really got one to swing, man. It was far out, I dug it. And dearie me, what a crummy singer. Going for the big hit, dancing down the pitch. Mistimed it completely and was clean bowled by Mark Elam. So it was a pretty good start there for the Sri Lankans under pressure in these difficult conditions, but then the middle order collapse started. When Nahir Van Gaal was a painter and he cut off his fucking ear, both went very cheaply. And in quick succession, here Van Gaal was a painter, caught behind off Wells for just 3. And a few balls later, he cut off his fucking ear. Didn't hear the call from his skipper, ran a tonga down a fractal, and eventually he took off, but he was always going to be struggling to make his ground. And in the end, fucking ear was nowhere fucking near it. Run out of the bowler's end for 2. The Sri Lankan skipper wasn't able to steady the ship either. In the very next over, Mark Elam had Ramatunga trapped plumb LBW for 6. And then came that 7th wicket stand between Akata Bunch of Lavender and shoved them into bars. Akata Bunch of Lavender put on 16 runs before he was caught at mid-on by Hollyoak off the bowling of Wells. And shoved them into bars was dismissed a short time later trying to lift Robert Croft over the infield. Didn't quite time it and was caught at deep cover by Graham Thorpe. It was a marvellous effort that from Thorpe. He came all the way around from where he was fielding there in the slips to take that catch. And Sri Lanka really in some deep foot at this stage with the score at 8 for 179. I feel like a chandra and I might need a poo too. Never look comfortable out there.
Yeah,
they were the next pair to come in for Sri Lanka, and with a fired up Darren Goff steaming in from the cathedral end, it was just a matter of time, and I feel like a chandra and I might need a poo too very quickly on the way back to the pavilion without adding to the Sri Lankan total. Like a chandra copped a brute of a ball. It flew off the pitch at alarming speed. Like a chandra just trying to get the fuck out of the way there, and it came off his glove and went straight through to the keeper, Stewart. And I might need a poo too. Just hanging the bat out to dry there, no footwork at all. A thick outside edge to Stewart. And Darren Goff brings the Sri Lankan innings to a close. The not-out batsman was an even crummier singer who didn't get to face a ball. And the final score, Sri Lanka, all out for 182. Well, the players and umpires not quite ready to come back out to the centre just yet. Just a few dark clouds starting to appear here at the Adelaide Oval. Not really looking too threatening, though, at the moment. And we should see both teams back out there in just... Ah! Ah! Ah!
We apologise for this breakdown in transmission. We seem to have lost our signal to the Adelaide Oval, but we hope to take you back to the cricket shortly.
We apologise for this interruption. To our apology, we hope...
Thanks, Walker.
Thanks, g'day,
Rob. Yeah, g'day, Rob. How's it going, mate?
Yeah, good to see you.
Oh, no worries, mate. As a matter of fact, I just got back from a jog. You're lucky to catch me.
Yeah, right, thanks, you, mate, too, mate.
No, I'm serious. I just walked through the door. Thanks, Walker.
Thanks.
Yes.
Richie Bennett.
Yeah, sure. Who is it? Rich, you're not still upset about that little bit of trouble we had at the SCG a couple of years ago, are you? Gee, fair suck of the old... Well, yeah, but geez, Rich, it was a couple of years ago. Gee, can't we just bury the hatchet? What is that?
Because they're going to add an extra commentator to the team this season. They've narrowed their choice down to two. And for some unknown bloody reason, you're one of them.
Oh, gee, Rich, you little Adjack. Ah, oh, that's great news. Oh, back in business.
Hey, shut the fuck up. I said they've narrowed it down to two. Did you
Gee, well, who else is there? Richie, who am I up against?
As a matter of fact, it's Ken. Ken Sunbridge.
Ken? Ken, the bloody male model from Budgie? Oh, you must be fucking joking. Oh, geez, Kenny wouldn't know one end of a cricket bat from the other. Why the hell would they want him as a commentator? Yeah, well, they're having a tremendous pull themselves if they reckon he's a better cricket commentator than me.
Max, it's got nothing to do with me. I'm just a captain of the commentary team. I take him over the selectors, get me. All I know is that down and get it yourself. And then weighing up
Ken's
bigger
pair
from the women
viewers
against your bigger
pair
of the
young ass
dickheads.
Yeah, well, so they bloody should.
So anyway, Max, the selection committee have instructed me to ring both you and Ken and let you know that I'll be watching your age programs very closely.
Shit, you're joking. It all hinges on one bloody show.
Look, that's what I've been told, Max. I've been watching the show today and making a decision
today. Well, I've got to tell you, I've got a pretty good feeling about this one, Richie.
Have you, Max?
I've got a feeling that job's as good as mine. Hey, listen, Rich, I suppose you're still on the selection committee, are you?
Yes, of course I am, Max. As captain of the commentary team, of course I get
that. Oh, yeah, right, of course. Hey, Rich, listen, have you got a copy of a new book yet? Oh, gee, well, I'll send you a copy. It's called Alligators and Arseholes. It's a little beauty. What about my board game? Have you got that?
Of course I have.
I'll send you a couple of copies of that, too. I'll autograph them for you.
Don't bother, Max.
Don't bother at all, mate. It'd be my pleasure. Hey, geez, Richie, this is great news, mate. I feel really good about this one. I'm really looking forward to working with you again. Wish me luck. Rich, you there? They must have been cut off. Go, little beauty! Yes, sir, back in action! Hey, Duff! Duff, wake up! Hey, Duff! Wake up, are you awake?
Yes, I'm awake, Max. What is it, Duff?
Great news, love. Looks like I'm going to be back on the commentary team with Richie and the boys this summer.
Oh, gee, that's good news. When did you find out about that?
Richie Benno just called and told me.
Richie Benno? I didn't think he was speaking to you after your hijacking.
No, that's all fine now, all forgotten.
Oh, good. Oh, congratulations, love.
Well, I haven't quite got the job yet. It's down to me and one other.
Oh, really? Do you know who?
Yes, it's Ken.
Ken Sutcliffe?
Yeah.
Oh, sexy eyes.
Oh, geez, I knew you'd say that.
Oh, that sexy voice.
Oh, come on, what about me?
Oh, yes, you're very good too, Max. But you know we all think Ken's a bit of a feedback, all the girls do.
Jeez. That's why they're thinking about him for the commentator's job, because he's a big hit with the ladies.
It's a good idea.
What about me? I'm the expert. I played the bloody game.
Yes, of course, darling. Of course you are. And that's why you'll probably get the job. What are you going to find out?
Oh, apparently the commentary team selection committee are going to be making a decision after they see how we both go on today's show.
Well, we better make sure you have a good one then. So you go and have your shower now, do a bit of practice. Make sure you warm your throat up, won't you?
Yes, okay, love.
I'll go and fix you a lovely big breakfast. Now, it's only 7:30, so take your time. Plane doesn't leave till 10.
Yes, thanks, love. I'll be down in a sec. Yes. Welcome back. Welcome back, yes, welcome back. That's over where, Maurice. The fourth test for all those overnight stories. Yes, good afternoon and welcome to another edition of Wired World of Sports. Geez, that sounded like the bloody Wide World of Sports music. Oh, geez, that sounded bloody fantastic. The boys at the studio are going to like this, mate. Hey, Dal.
Yes, welcome back. Great to have you come here in the kitchen for this edition of Fried World of Breakfast. Come on, love. Let's hear a little bit. Come on. Welcome back.
Yes, and still ahead on the Fried World of Breakfast, we'll be giving the old dentures a workout as we crunch our way through a big bowl of muesli. Plus, we'll be enjoying a citrus extravaganza as we pump in plenty of the old vitamin C with a huge glass of OJ. And we'll take you live to Cholesterol City for some of the finest fried eggs with bacon and tomato you've ever seen. All that and a couple of pieces of golden brown wholemeal toast.
Coming up. Yes, well done. Sounding great, love. What would you like on your toast?
Just a bit of the old veggie, I think, love. Yes, had a pretty good warm-up in the shower. Hey, listen, speaker, shower, have a listen to this. I discovered I can play this tune while I'm blowing my nose. It's great, isn't it?
Yes.
Hey, what do you reckon about that?
Oh, it's great.
Yeah, I can't wait to show the fellas at the station. I reckon I should use it at the start of the show today.
There you go, love. Yes, well, that'd be great. Might be a good idea to use a hanky though, love.
Yes, I think you're probably right. Just give us a tissue in the meantime, will you, love? Better give us a couple more.
Just a little bit on your tie there, love.
Yeah. Oh, right. Yes, it still sounds fantastic, though, doesn't it?
Yes, it's very good, love.
Yeah, I reckon the punters out there would love it. That's what they want, a bit of the old Aussie larrikin. Just be there and done it. Not a bloody bale bottle from Budgie. Same with the cricket. I'm a former test player. I've been a commentator, kid's just a...
Pretty face.
Oh, geez, you're right, are you? Pretty face, dreamboat. Geez, you really got me worried about this commentator's job. I thought I might have been a bit of a shoo-in.
Oh, look, you probably are, love.
Well, obviously I'm not. They decided to go for the big push on a female audience, it sounds like I could miss out. What could I do to make myself look a bit sexier for today's show? What?
A bag. Have you got a bag to
take in? Oh. Oh, yeah, I have. Thanks. Hey, listen, do you think I should try a new hairstyle today?
Max, you try a new hairstyle on the show every week, love. You look fine. Well, listen, speaking of the show, Rob called last night while you were out. He said he'd call again this morning, but we haven't heard.
Oh, fuck.
What is it, love?
Oh, fuck.
What's the matter?
Oh, bud, my fucking French, love, but oh, fuck.
What's
oh,
happened?
Oh, I fucked up.
What's
oh, I called back this morning to tell me I want an earlier flight and I fell back to sleep and I forgot all about it. Oh, jeez.
Oh.
What time is it?
It's 10 to
9. Oh, fuck. Oh, I'm supposed to be on a 9 o'clock flight. Oh, jeez.
Oh,
oh, wouldn't you bloody know it, but it's an important show.
Come on, stay calm.
Oh, shit. Look, I'll have to take the car to the airport, love.
All right.
You reckon book me a seat on the 10 o'clock, will you?
All right, love.
Oh, now, bloody hell.
Have you got everything?
Oh, geez, I don't know.
Do you want me to go to the station and tell them what's happening?
No, shit, no, don't do that. I'll just get there as quick as I can. I'll have to think of some story to tell. And if the phone rings, don't answer it.
All right then, love.
Jeez.
Now, don't panic. There's still plenty of time before the show. Give us a kiss.
Yeah, right, eh, love. I'll talk to you a bit later. I've got to run.
Okay, love. Good luck.
Yeah, thanks. Love to Ken.
G'day, mate. Yeah, g'day, pal. Channel 9, thanks.
Yeah, no, mate. No worries, mate.
Hey, mate, I'm in a real hurry. My plane was late. I'll give you an extra $10 if you can get me there in 20 minutes, okay?
Mate, you make it $20 and I'll get you there in 30 minutes, mate.
You got a deal, pal. Let's go.
So, listen, mate, I can be doing the show on a Saturday.
What do you mean?
A show. A midday show. It's never on a Saturday, is it, mate?
I'm not on the bloody midday show, pal. I'm on the Wide World of Sports. Hey, keep your eyes on the road, will you, pal? Jeez. Fair sake of the old celebrity, pal. If you don't kid, you must know me, Maxie Walker.
Ah, that's right, man. No, I remember. I do remember now.
Big Max.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, Big Max. Yeah. What are the hamburgers?
Yeah. No, not like the bloody hamburgers.
No, just Big Max. Yeah.
Hey,
I'm pleased to have met you, Max. My name's Theo fucking
Owens. Yeah, g'day, Theo. What's the bloody road, will you, pal? Jeez.
No, no, it's okay, man. It's funny because I always remember Kenny Suckley's name, you know, because what it was always going on about what a spunky guy is, you know?
Really?
Yeah, man, she's always saying that he looks really sexy, you know, got sexy eyes, and if he should be on TV or what more, stuff like that, you know?
Jeez, you're joking, aren't you?
No, man, I'm feeling it, man. My wife, my two daughters, my man, all the girls really like him, man. Yeah, I can see why, man, you know, he's pretty bloody good.
Let's see this girl
go. I'm sorry, mate, what did you say?
Nothing, mate, I'm just... Hey, what's the bloody road, will ya?
Okay,
jeez, you're gonna kill me.
Okay, no, I'll be lost, mate.
So good. Such a typical 90s Sydney taxi driver.
Okay, Theo, you bloody maniac, what's the damage?
Let me see, mate, that's $17, plus the extra $20, that's $37, mate.
Yeah, there you go, there's $40.
Hey, mate!
Keep the charge.
Do you reckon you could do us a big favour, mate?
No, I'm in a hurry,
do
mate.
Do you reckon you could get Kenny Suckley sort of crap from me and my wife?
Yeah, no worries, Theo.
Right.
Just give us my change, mate, I'll go and get it for you.
Gee, thanks a lot, mate.
Nah, better still, Theo. You wait right there and I'll send him out to do it for you in person.
Jeez, mate, he's not going to want to do that, is he, mate?
Yeah, of course he will. Kenny loves signing autographs. You wait right there and I'll send him out.
Gee, thanks a lot.
Tomorrow.
Mr. Walker, there you are. They've been looking for you everywhere.
Yeah, I know, security. Where's Rob at the moment, you know?
Yes, he's down at Mr. Sutcliffe's dressing room, I think.
Righto, thanks.
Maxie, where have you been? Everyone's been
looking. Oh, really, Dave? Jeez, what do you think I'm running for, my bloody elf?
Maxie, where have you been?
Ah, fuck, you wouldn't believe it. A bloody car broke down on the way to the airport and I missed a plane.
Oh, no, really? Oh, and you had to jog all the way to Tullamarine.
Eh?
just kidding you, Maxie.
Yeah, right. Very funny. Anyway, listen, I'm sorry I'm late. There's nothing I can do about it.
No, it's cool anyway. It's okay.
Anyhow, what about these changes? Let's get down to business. You got the new scripts?
Mate, it's covered. Everything's cool. Ken's got the new intro to the surfing piece that you were going to do. We've rehearsed that. And he's learnt the intro for the new story as well, the cricket story. So as it turns out, there's no
doubt. The what story?
The cricket story. You know, the behind the scenes look at the commentary.
Yeah, I know the story. I saw a bit of it being edited this week. I know the fucking story.
Yeah? Well?
Well?
Well, what?
Oh, all right then, so we're not even going to talk about the new commentator's job being announced tonight, is that it?
Shit, that's right. That's tonight, isn't it? That's right. Yes, I was talking to Richie yesterday, you reminded me. Yeah, well, good luck to both of you.
Oh, thanks, Rob. Good luck, Maxie.
Yeah, well, sounds like I'm going to need more than luck now, I reckon.
What do you mean, Max?
Oh, gee, well, you know, the cricket story, the new commentator's job.
Maxie.
Selectors are going to be watching the show. Gee, fair sake of the old setup.
Jeez, Max, it's only an intro, mate.
Yeah, Maxie, it's no big deal.
Yeah, well, I'm not so sure about that.
What do you mean?
Well, I know is I usually intro all the cricket stuff on the show. Played the bloody game for my country, I've got the cred supposedly, now I've lost the surfing piece too.
Oh, you're the Max.
I'm just a bit disappointed that a decision like this was made without me being here.
Yeah, well, you know, we're all a bit disappointed you weren't here, Max, but unfortunately, due to circumstances, you weren't here. And Saul and I decided it really wasn't a big deal and Kenny could handle it on his ear.
Yeah, well, I suppose I'm just going to have to wear it then, aren't I?
And anyway, Max, like you said, you're the one who's played the game.
That's right, Ken's right.
You've got the creds, so...
Exactly. So, you know, you've worked with Richie and the boys before, too. So, mate, you've got as much chance as Ken. Oh, shit, Ken, speaking of Richie, didn't he get hold of you about doing those autographed photos for his wife and her friends?
Yes, he did.
Oh, good. Yeah, no, I forgot to mention it to you.
It's already done. I've sent them over to him.
Oh, fantastic.
50 bloody autographs.
Oh, no.
I thought my hand was
going to
drop off.
Oh, 50, was it?
Yes, I bet you did.
Anyhow, listen, fellas, I'll leave you to run over your scripts. I've got to go down and check on a few things down on the floor, OK?
OK, Rob.
Yes, OK, Rob.
So, Max, I hope there's no hard feelings about the cricket story and the circus.
Well, I am a little bit pissed off, to tell you the truth, Ken. I mean, it's an important bloody show, and I've lost one story, and then a cricket story comes on, and you're doing it, you know what I mean?
It's no big deal.
Well, I think it is a big deal, Ken, you know, with the commentator's job being announced.
Just hang on a sec, Maxie. Hello, Ken Sutcliffe. Oh, hi. Just give me a sec, will you? Maxie, I just need a little bit of privacy for a moment, mate.
Yeah, righto, Ken.
Look, I'll catch up with you later, okay?
Yeah, sure thing, mate. No worries. I'll see you down at Baker.
Hello, Richie.
Sorry,
Richie.
Richie, eh? Yeah, bloody cosy.
Oh, I can talk
with
him.
Oh, that's good.
No,
I'm not. You bloody sucker.
No, I really appreciate
it,
mate.
You bastard.
Well, I've
been working here too. Oh, puke.
Well, I don't know if I
could
be that confident.
Well,
that's terrific, Richie. I just hope you have a place to feel the same way.
Right, that's it. That's it. Oh,
gee, Richie, that'd be a tremendous
help. You bastard.
Okay, mate. Thanks very much, Richie.
All right,
mate.
All right, man.
Ciao.
You bastard.
Well, welcome back to the FCG. And Australia right on top here in the early overs. Welcome back. England now 2-22. 2-22. Oh, that's a great shot. It's the pad, that's a big appeal. Ooh!
And that's out, Kenny, my boy. I'm sorry to have to do this, but I'm afraid I can't let bloody male model from Budgie rob me of my rightful place on the commentary fucking team. Right. Yeah, where is bloody scripts? There, here they are. Right, let's have a look here. There we go, right. Well, as we all know, Nine's Wide World of Sports Logie winning cricket coverage is one of the most popular sporting telecasts anywhere in the world. Each summer in Australia, the doyen of cricket commentators, Richie Beddoe, and his team of experts, which includes former greats Bill Laurie and Tony Gregg, the Chandler brothers Gregg and Ian, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, well, this looks okay. And as the season 94-95 draws closer, we thought we'd go behind the scenes with Richie and the fellas. See what makes the fellas tick. And we check out the rigorous and often grueling commentary practice sessions Beto puts them through in preparation for the season ahead. Yeah, well, that all sounds pretty bloody easy, piece of piss. Geez, if Kenny can handle that on his ear, I can handle that and every other bloody thing on my ear. And Maxie, have you seen... Shit, Max, what have you done to your hair? What do you mean? I've had it cut. It's a new style.
Jeez, Max, why don't you leave your bloody hair alone? You have a new style every week. Shit, what colour is it?
Well, I think they call it smoky silver.
Jeez, Max, I wish you'd leave your bloody hair alone. Anyway, listen, have you seen Ken?
No, I haven't, mate.
Shit, I can't seem to find him. It's only 25 minutes till showtime. It's not like him to go and walk about now. He hasn't even been a makeup.
Shit, eh?
Yeah.
Well, geez, do you reckon I better run an eye over his scripts just in case?
Just in case what, Max?
Well, just in case he doesn't make it back.
What do you mean, just in case he doesn't make it back?
Just in case he doesn't make it back from wherever it is he's gone.
Max, of course he's going to be here. You better bloody well hurry up, though. Hey, Zippy, this is Rob. Any sign of him down there on the floor? Well, so make that reception to page him urgently again, will you? Tell him he's wanted in makeup now.
Geez, he's probably just ducked up the shops to get a milkshake or something. Rob, he'll be back in a sec. Maybe he's going to get some smokes.
Get some smokes? What are you bloody talking about, Max? Ken doesn't smoke.
Oh, yeah, right. Jeez. Oh, well, I don't know. Maybe he's thinking of taking it up. I'm just saying, he can't be too far away.
Well, I hope you're right, Max. Anyway, listen, I better get back to the control room.
Hey, listen, Rob, before you go, I want to show you something, mate.
Yeah, it's quickly, Max. What is it, mate?
You're going to love this, mate. It'll cheer you up. It's great.
Yeah, come on, quickly. What is it?
Okay, listen to this. Name this tune. Well, did you pick it? Listen again.
Max, what the hell are you doing? I said I was in a hurry.
Well, have you got it yet? It's the bloody theme music from the start of the show. The Wide World of Sports music.
Is, Max, I know what it is. That's very clever.
Isn't it? Well, I reckon it is. I reckon I should do it at the start of the show. You know, just open up my microphone where the music starts and I'll come in with the old schnozzer.
Max, you are kidding, aren't you?
Nah, come on, it'd be great.
No, Jesus, Max.
What the bloody public love me for? The Aussie bookie, flaky, larrikin kind of humour, they love it.
Dream about it, Max. Oh, we're not doing it.
Oh, come on, Rob, this is a big show for me, mate.
I'm telling you, Max.
The team selectors watching and everything, I'd like a chance to show what I could do.
Maxie, it'll be an even bigger show, mate, if you don't do that, okay?
Jeez. Trust me.
Now here, wipe your hands.
Yeah, thanks.
There's a bit on your lapel too.
Right.
Now listen, we're not doing it, okay? Now get yourself ready, go over your scripts, and I'll see you down on the set in about 10 minutes.
Yeah, righto, Rob, I'll see you there, babe. Oh, jeez. If I know Zippy, I don't know where he is.
This is the control room to all departments, so if anyone knows anything at all that might help us locate Ken, could they contact security or the control room urgently, please? We've only got about 5 minutes till we're on air, and we've got no idea where he's gone or why. So if you think you might be able to help, please contact security or the control room urgently. Thank you.
Thanks very much, Ken. Maxie, good afternoon.
Listen, I'll tell you what, it's never bloody happened to me before in 26 years of television. The bloody host disappearing 10 minutes before the bloody show starts.
Yeah, it's a bloody mystery, Zippy, that's for sure. I mean, where the hell would he go just before showtime without telling anyone? That's what's got me bugging.
Thanks very much, Ken. Maxie, good afternoon.
I hope nothing's happened to him. You know, you might have to fly solo today, mate.
Thanks very much, Ken. Maxie, good afternoon.
Yes, well, I'll handle it if I have to.
Control room to the next. Can you hear me, Maxie?
Yes, Rob, I can hear you, mate.
Mate, I'm afraid Kim is still a no-show. I think we're going to hang up in long term enough. You know, we've got 5 minutes to go. And I'm afraid at this stage, it's like you might have to do the show on your own, mate.
Yeah, well, that'll be no worries for me, Rob.
Well, I'm sorry, Maxie. We've run his mobile, his car's still in the car park, he's nowhere to see Max, quite a mystery, so it looks like you're in, mate.
Shit, eh? Well, I'll just have to do my best, Rob. Look, I'll be fine, Rob, really, I'll just wing it, mate.
You reckon you can do that
until
he gets in?
Mate, I'm a pro, Rob. Everything will be fine.
Religion,
Maxie.
We'll get back in a couple of minutes, mate.
Oh,
there you go,
Maxie.
It's a big call, mate.
Oh, yeah, Zippy, she'll be cool, mate. Everything will be just fine.
Perhaps.
Hey, listen, fellas. Fellas, I've got something to show you. You're going to love this. Jeez, Bear, can you give it a break for a sec, pal?
Yeah, what have you got for us, Maxie?
Right, you blokes, watch this. Okay, Dave, this tune.
Isn't it?
Oh, you
bloody maniac walker.
Hey, isn't it great? Yeah, that's a pearl, isn't it? Yeah, I knew this huge fucking schnozzle might have come in here sometime. Hey, listen, I'm going to do it at the start of the show, you know, when the music comes on. So make sure the audio boys keep a microphone open, will you?
Oh, shit, mate. I think I better check with Rob and
Sorrel. No, I've already checked with them, Zippy. I wasn't going to do it without checking with them. They love it.
Oh, well,
they reckon it's great.
Okay, then, no worries. Audio, did you hear that?
Thanks very much, Maxie. Yeah, thanks, mate. Great. Thanks, mate. 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 Thanks, mate.
That's a good one, mate.
Thanks very much. Thanks for having
the view. Is there any soft in there,
No, mate. No sound of him at all.
Thanks very much, mate. Good afternoon to you.
All right, stand by, everyone, please. 2 minutes. Make sure you just say Ken's not well or something, will you, mate?
Yes, Rob, something like that, mate. I'll think of something.
Thanks very much.
For fuck's sake, Bear, will you stop bloody rehearsing? You sound fine.
Thanks very much, mate.
Jeez. Hey, listen, have any of you fellas bought my bloody board game yet? Thanks a bloody lot. What about alligators and arseholes? Has anyone got a copy of that yet? Thanks a fucking lot.
I've just one for Christmas, Maxie.
Oh, look, I'm telling you, you'll love them both. The book's piss funny and the game's a little pearler.
Yeah, that's no, sure. I'm
bring
sure.
them in when you get them and I'll sign them for you.
Thanks very much, mate. That'd be great.
All right, everyone, 30 seconds. Stand by, please. Good luck, Maxie. Intro music and after the reader roll, please. Okay, buddy, here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Today on the Wired World of Sports, we bring you all the latest on the sensational AFL Todd Shorts controversy, and we speak to some of the players as well. As cricket season 94-95 approaches, we catch up with Richie and the boys in a revealing behind-the-scenes profile of the commentary team. Once again, we'll be making someone's day in our Forgettable Sporting Moments giveaway, where we'll be putting up for grabs $5 cash. We take you to the USA for lobster racing, Yes, it's the new sport that's taken America by storm, and today we go to bumfuck Idaho for the national championships. We'll have you bored shitless as we go sailing the high seas with some more fat rich pricks in yet another brewery-sponsored ocean classic. For rugby league fans, we'll have all the action from on the field and up in the commentary box with Raps, Fatty and Sturlo in this month's fantastic edition of Footy Fever. Plus, we'll be pulling the lycra right up your clacker with our coverage of the Women's World Aerobics Championships from Las Vegas. For the Waxheads and Findex, it's off to Hawaii for all the thrills and spills in this year's Tsunami Tidal Wave Classic. We take you to the small country town of Ustinki in Finland for this year's World's Strongest Man competition. Racing today comes from Royal Randwick, and we'll be bringing you the last five races live. Plus, minus, add, subtract, divide. Multiplying your sports entertainment this afternoon, this is the one and only Wide World of Sports.
Yes, hello and welcome to another marathon innings of spectacular sporting action. Thanks for joining me here at the crease, and a special cheerio to my old batting partner Kenny Sutcliffe this afternoon, who's retired hurt. Hope you'll be back on your feet soon, kid. But right now, over at the sports desk, the former skipper of the St. Patrick's under-13Bs, Ian Maurice, is padded up and ready for his first delivery of all those overnight scores from home and abroad.
Thanks very much, Munchie. Good afternoon to you and to everyone. And Ken, if you're watching, hurry back, mate. We miss you. Okay, in rugby league, the Kangaroos completed a whitewash of the England team last night with a 108-point victory in the third and final test. Now, if you don't want to know the score because you've taped the game while you're out getting shit-faced and chasing chicks and you've only just woken up and haven't had time to watch the tape yet, look away now. Oh, fuck me, drunk. What a drubbing. 112 points to four in a very lopsided and often spiteful encounter. Big Paul Soonan coming in for some special attention from some of the England forwards. The Australian giant needing a precautionary